Welcome everybody to Dare Graduation 2018 at Northfield Elementary. I would like to welcome all the parents and visitors, other relatives and family, students, teachers, and some of our guests we have over here. Before we get started, I'd like to introduce my fellow co-workers. We'll start in the front here with Sergeant Scott Newberg, Officer Ava Radley, Principal Dr. Gene Lloyd, I think y'all know him. Later on, I'll introduce this man a little bit more, but he'll be your guest speaker. This is Mr. Jonathan Pope. Behind Mr. Pope is Officer Chris Williams. Go on down the line is Major Clyde Atkinson. Behind Major is my Lieutenant Gary Carter. We have Officer Bill Dry and Officer Jay Radzinski. And last but not least, I'll call a few students up here. We'll start this off with our Pledge of Allegiance. If I call your name, come stand right here in front of us and we'll lead it together. Carter Rankin, Alex Roman, Regan Warren, and Annabeth Pennington. We'd like to also ask everybody if you'll stand. DARE, Drug Abuse Resistance Education, started in 1983 by former Police Chief Daryl Gates of the Los Angeles Police Department. The Murfreesboro Police Department has been teaching DARE in the city schools since 1992 and continues to teach in all 10 city schools and two private schools, which include MTCS and St. Rose. DARE is currently taught in 80% of the United States school district and in 54 countries around the world. DARE is a cooperative effort between law enforcement and the school system. A uniformed police officer will teach a 10-week course of study to show the students how they can live and be productive, drug and violent free. Some of these topics that we've discussed these 10 weeks include decision-making skills, risk and consequences, pressure, dealing with stress, bullying, being part of a community, the health effects of drug and alcohol, responding to peer pressure, and communication skills along with empathy. As you can see, DARE is a life skills class. It is not a drug identification program. At no point do we bring any drugs or anything like that in to show the students. With our graduation today, these students are joining over 37 million DARE students who have benefited and graduated from the DARE program. Without any further ado, I'd like to welcome and ask Dr. Gene Lloyd to come up here and say a few words. Thanks, sir.
Like Officer Glass said, thank you very much to the parents and friends who have come out today. Thank you to our teachers who give up part of their day to allow DARE to be taught. I want to say thank you to Officer Glass. Let's give him a hand. Well, I appreciate about him, he's come into our school and just become part of us, and we look forward to many more days with him. And so thank you to him for being a part and sharing with each one of you. Something I heard him say that I hadn't heard, really paid much attention to. I knew DARE was across the U.S., but 54 countries, I mean, that's pretty big. So you're part of something that goes on everywhere. So congratulations to you. So the next people I would like to acknowledge, and you will be acknowledged individually in a minute, but just give you all a hand for making it through DARE. I want to thank each gentleman and lady who is here today. I think I'm sitting over there and feel safer than I have ever felt in a while. So we appreciate them. They do so much for us, and they keep us safe, and they keep an eye on us more than you probably ever know. And so I really appreciate each one. Everyone has probably been by our school at some time or another this year. So thank you to them. At this time, I'm going to turn it back over to Officer Glass, and congratulations once again to each one of you.
So along with DARE classes, there are some graduation requirements. These do include class attendance, participation in class, discussions, and there's also a workbook that we fill out. Along with all of these things, at the end of the semester, we have the students write what we call the DARE essay. Possible topics for this essay that students may include are, you know, their feelings about the DARE program. They can write about what they've learned in the program, and they can also add, you know, why they think it's important to be drug-free, make better decisions, and be able to do better with peer pressure. For each class, we've all selected three winners. Every winner will get a prize, but the first place winner from each class will come up and share their essay with everybody. It's a big thing they look forward to, obviously. Along with the DARE essays, we also pick, I say we, I'm talking about the students, they vote a DARE boy and a DARE girl from each class. This is not something that I choose. This is not something that the teacher chooses. This is not a popular vote. This is a student they select that they think is already a role model and a leader that they think will live a drug-free and violent-free life. So it's pretty outstanding thing to be recognized for the DARE boy and DARE girl. Before we give out those awards, I will call the teacher's name. They'll come up to the podium and give out their class certificates. Once they get done, we'll give out the essay awards and the DARE boy and girl awards. The only thing that I ask from the audience and from the students, hold your applause until all the certificates are given out. I promise you we'll have time to make all the noise and holler all we want afterwards. So first I would like to call up Dr. Knox.
We'd also like to thank Officer Glass for all his work that he's done with all of our classes. He's done things above and beyond coming to DARE class. He goes out and plays football with these guys, and he knows just about all of them by name. And so we appreciate everything that he does. If you will hold your applause until I get through all of my class, and then we will applaud at the end. Hunter Bradford. Ian Buckley. Desay Dow. Jacob Elvington. AJ Gaines. Lauren Giddens. Brianna Guthrie. Chase Hall. Xavier Mathewson. Caden McGraw. Michaela Mears. Carly Padilla. Annabeth Pennington. Graydon Schlinker. Krista Smith. Kong Bo. Mary Lynn Walker. Colby Ward. Iamani Watts. Emily Wells. And Noah Wright. If you'll give these ladies and gentlemen a big round of applause.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Ladies first, we'll start with Miss Dr. Knox's Girl Award goes to Annabeth Pennington. Dr. Knox's Dare Boy is Noah Wright. Third place essay for Dr. Knox's class, Ian Buckley. Second place, Annabeth Pennington. And last but not least, first place goes to Emily Wells.
Thank you.
Dare, define, assess, respond, and evaluate. There were some very important things I learned in DARE. In the next three paragraphs, I will be telling you what I learned, how I have used the DARE decision-making model, and how I plan to use what I've learned to make safe and responsible choices. I have learned many important things in DARE. I have learned that tobacco is a bad and a very addictive type of drug. It contains nicotine, which makes you addicted, and has over 200 harmful chemicals in the smoke. We have learned how to problem solve and get out of any bad or potentially harmful situations. I have learned how to report bullying. For example, you can use the 5 W's of reporting bullying. I have learned how alcohol slows down the brain. I learned how drugs are bad for you and how you need to stay away from them, and if you find them, you need to tell someone about it. DARE stands for Drug Abuse Resistance in Education. You can use the DARE decision-making model in many different situations. You need to describe the problem, challenge, or opportunity. You need to ask, what are your choices? You need to make a choice. And you need to gather the facts and information you have to help you. You need to review your decision. Did you make a good choice? I plan to use what I've learned from DARE to make safe and responsible choices. I have learned to make safe choices, like if someone offers you cigarettes, you can change the subject and say, like, let's go play outside. I can be responsible by telling somebody when there is a problem. I can make safe choices, like while playing soccer, you have to follow the rules so you can play a safe game. I have learned many things in DARE. I promise to stay safe and responsible. I know how to use the DARE decision-making model in situations. These were some important things I learned in DARE.
Congratulations. You did really good. Thank you. Congratulations to Dr. Knox's class one more time. Next, I'd like to ask Ms. Kelly and her class to come forward.
I would just like to thank Officer Glass for coming and talking to our class for 10 weeks. My students have really enjoyed learning from him and spending time with him. So thank you, Officer Glass. Please hold your applause till all of my class has gone through. Isser Abdulrahman. Savannah Brown. Bryson Floyd. Antonio Grady. Will Harbison. Kinsley Coombs. Matthew Lewis. Devin McCurley. Dawson Oliver. Logan Pilkington. Carter Rankin. Cole Rhodes. Lexi Sweat. William Wade. CJ Walters. Reagan Warren. Zaria Wilson. And I have one student who's not here today, Cole Johnson. I just wanted to recognize him as well.
Dear girl for Miss Kelly's class, Regan Warren. Congratulations. And the dear boy for Miss Kelly's class, William Wade. Third place essay winner, Lexi Sweat.
Congratulations.
Second place, Zaria Wilson. And last but not least, first place winner, Reagan Warren.
DARE, Drug, Abuse, Resistance, and Education. These are the way DARE has helped me to make decisions. During these last 10 weeks, my peers and I have been going through DARE, learning how to keep ourselves and others around us safe. We have learned how to stay healthy, handle situations, how to communicate, and how to report. We have learned how and when to use the DARE decision-making model. Overall, we have learned how to use all that we have learned during these last 10 weeks. DARE has taught my peers and I many things about how to take care of ourselves and each other. We are aware of the health effects of alcohol, tobacco, and drugs. We have learned ways to communicate our feelings and communicate with adults. I have learned to report and who to report to in a situation. All of these things are important to advising, education, and the safety of the people around me. The DARE decision-making model was designed to help children and teens understand and make decisions in a tough situation. The DARE decision-making model can be used in multiple situations. It can be used in situations involving alcohol, tobacco, and drugs, bullying, peer pressure, etc. The DARE decision-making model is a very important part of our DARE education. We have been prepared to use the DARE decision-making model in the present and future. My peers and I will be prepared for sticky situations to come. In DARE, I have learned so many things, but most importantly, I've learned how to use these things in the years to come. My peers and I will use the ways to handle stress and pressure through our years of middle school, high school, and hopefully college and a job. We will use the resistance strategies for the rest of our lives whenever temptation comes knocking at our doors. We will use the reporting and communication strategies for the rest of our lives, whether it's reporting bullying or a murder. With DARE, I have learned so much. We've learned how to use the DARE decision-making model, define, assess, respond, and evaluate. I have learned health effects, resistance strategies, and signs of stress. How to communicate, reporting, and my health network. My peers and I have grown so much through the last 10 weeks. We definitely know how to keep it real.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Well deserved. One thing that I did forget to mention before we started giving out awards is I did not get a single bad essay. It was a very hard, difficult choice for me and my peers to make. So just wanted every one of y'all to know that y'all did an outstanding job and I'm proud of you guys. Next, I would like to ask Ms. LeMay and her class to come forward.
Thanks, parents, for being here. We appreciate your support for your children. It means a lot to your children. It means a lot to us. And thank you, Officer Glass. We've enjoyed having you in the classroom. So please hold your applause until the end of my group. We'll start with Mesa Abuzara. Kaylin Brooks. Hannah Burchett. Sarah Faith Connolly Thomas. Carson Easley. Abby Gibbs. Mason Hargett. Bree Harrelson. Addison Hayes. Dylan Knox. Aiden McGee. Peter McKinney. Anthony Merritt. Caleb Payne. Jordan Sanders. Ethan Swain. Shaylin Wright. Matthew Young. And we had one student that was absent today, Lincoln Rich, so we'd like to honor him as well.
Thank you.
Okay, there it is.
Thank you.
The Dare Girl from Miss LeMay's class, Addison Hayes. Dare Boy from Miss LeMay's class, Dylan Knox. Third place essay award goes to Shaylin Wright. Second place goes to Mesa Abuzara. And the first place award goes to Addison Hayes.
You may think of DARE as something scary or hard, but DARE is none of those. DARE stands for Drug Abuse Resistance Education. It is a lesson to be safe and kind to not just you, but to others. Some examples of being safe are not to smoke and to not do drugs. Smoking is very bad for you. If you do it for a long time, it will be hard to breathe. Drugs are bad for you too. Many people offer you some, but the safe thing to do is say no. You can get addicted to both smoking and drugs. Being kind is important. Ways of being kind are helping people carry things, maybe even telling somebody to not smoke or do drugs. Kind is the key. Helping people makes them feel happy and maybe even makes you happy. I have learned many things in DARE. When I get older, I think the things that we learned will come in handy. How I plan to incorporate that in the future is to teach my kids and other kids DARE. In my opinion, when I am older, I think I will obey all the rules we learned in DARE. DARE is something to be serious about. It is a life lesson that can help you one day. You have to make sure you are safe and kind to you and others. Also, your health is very important.
Congratulations. And last but not least, I'd like to ask Ms. Lewis and her class to come forward.
And my class and I would like to thank Officer Glass for a wonderful DARE experience this year. Please hold your applause. Rahman Ali. Riley Allen. Navon Boyd. Sarah Chavis. Rosie Ferrello. Mia Gaines. Melody Elig. Isaac Lambert. Fiona Mallory. Gracie O'Gwen. Mayor Patel. Tyler Radke. Alex Romine. James Ruffner. Edric Sanchez. Jalen Summerauer. Micah Taiwu. Christopher Tienda. And Darnell Williams.
Okay.
A little different. Third place essay award for Ms. Lewis's class goes to James Ruffner. Second place goes to Fiona Mallory. I'm gonna let the suspense build and skip over to the Boy and Girl Award. I skipped that, so I apologize. The Dare Girl for Ms. Lewis's class is Sarah Chavis. And the Dare Boy Award also goes to James Ruffner. Now we'll skip back to the essay. The first place award winner goes to Micah Taiwu.
Good job, buddy. Dare is a program that can help you through troubled times. You can learn about it from your school officers. DARE is not only for minors, it's also for adults too. The DARE program can teach you many things that can affect your life in many ways. During DARE, I have learned many things to do that could help you in situations. The program taught me to not take drugs and how it affects your body. They also teach you what to do when someone is being bullied, having pressure on you, and how to be a good citizen. The DARE decision-making model is used in programs that could have negative consequences or could break your friend's heart. If you don't know how to use the DARE decision-making model, the first step is to define, describe the problem, challenge, or opportunity. The second step is to assess, which means to make choices. Afterwards, you respond, make a choice using the facts and information you have collected. And finally, you evaluate, which means to write a sentence by using the choice you have chosen, make sure you made the best choice. So your answer can solve the problem. Drug abuse resistance education is really important. It can help you make the right decision so you can have a good life. Stay away from drugs and tobacco, and remember to do this. Keep it real.
Good job, Dave. Congratulations. Let's give it up for everybody one more good time. At this time, I would like to introduce our guest speaker. He not only serves our country as a U.S. drill sergeant, he also serves our community right here in Murfreesboro as a police officer as well. So everybody sit up straight and give Jonathan Pope a big welcome.
So all the parents were back in the back as they were coming in, were looking at the hat and the uniform and everything. They probably think I'm about to make you do push-ups or let's go run a couple of miles or something like that. The truth is we're about to. So are you ready to go run a couple of miles and do some push-ups and stuff?
Yes.
You say that. Hey, if everybody's ready to go back to class, right?
No.
No? So you want me to make it like long and drawn out or you want me to make it short? Yeah, unfortunately it's going to be a little short, okay? So let me introduce myself. My name is Jonathan Pope. This Cole, as Officer Glass said, I've known Officer Glass for a few years now. We've been on the street together for a little bit. I joined the Army when I was 18 years old. I left 5 days after I graduated high school. I cried my little eyes out in basic training, wanted to go home to Mama and Daddy, wanted to eat some cake and ice cream, wanted to drink some Coca-Cola, couldn't do any of that anymore. Went to basic training, finished my job training, came back home. I've been on and off active duty for a little while ever since then. They send us, we are reserve drill sergeants, so they send us to, you know, Fort Jackson, Fort Benning, Fort Sill, Oklahoma. I've trained soldiers all over the world. I've been deployed once. So I got a little bit of experience, and I just want to thank Officer Glass for having me get the opportunity to come speak to you guys every day, because it starts now, it starts where you're at. The Army has 7 values that we all live by, okay? It's the Army's core set of values or morals, if you want to put it that way. There's one moral overall that supersedes all the others, and that is integrity. Does anybody know what the definition of integrity is? Raise your hand if you know the definition of integrity. Okay, we got some people falling asleep. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to get a little bit interactive. So I'm going to have to move away from this mic because I'm going to get a little loud. Okay? I'm going to say, on your feet. When I say on your feet, I'm going to do it in a loud, thunderous tone. You already got the idea. Sorry if you got your papers, put it underneath the chair. I'm going to say on your feet in a loud and thunderous tone. At that time, you're going to pop up out of your seat as fast as you can. You're going to stand as still as possible. Yes? Shake your head yes if you understand. Yes? So when I say on your feet, you're going to stand up as fast as you can. You're going to stand as still as possible. Yes? When I say take seats, you're going to sit down as quickly as possible and not move. Do you understand? Yes? Shake your head yes?
Sir.
Yes. Ready? We're going to try it out, okay? Move away from this because I'll blow that mic. On your feet! Not supposed to move. Don't move. Head, seat. Don't move. Can't move. On your feet. Head, seat. Try again. On your feet. Head, seat. Okay. The definition of integrity. The definition of integrity. My definition of integrity. The best definition of integrity. Is to always do the right thing, even when no one is looking. So this time, I'm going to say on your feet, and I'm going to say always do the right thing, and all of you are going to scream, even when no one is looking. Yes? Who does not understand? If you don't understand, and we get it wrong, we're going to do push-ups. So I'm going to say on your feet. Everybody's going to stand up. and say, always do the right thing. You're going to say, even when no one else is looking. And then I'm going to tell you to take seats. Yes? On your feet. Always do the right thing. Always do the right thing. Take seat. Not supposed to move. On your feet. Always do the right thing. Take seat. I want to tell you a little short story, and I got a little story about myself. It's about this kid that, somebody told me a story about. His name is Tanner. He was playing baseball. He loved to play baseball. Baseball was his favorite sport of all time. Who's the favorite sport of baseball? Anybody? Anybody like baseball? Okay. So when he always played first base, and whenever he played first base, there were several times when the ball would get hit to him. He would go down. He would get the ball. He would run towards the first base to either try to tag the player out who hit the ball, or he would try to step on the bag, which means he would be out. Yes? He would be out. So there were three or four times when he was running to try to tag that player out that he did not tag the player, and the umpire would call him out anyways. So he would go up to the umpire, and he'd say, hey, umpire, I didn't tag him, or hey, umpire, I didn't step on the bag. And the umpire would be like, oh, okay, well, then he's safe. There was one time the ball got hit to him. He leans down. He gets it. He runs over to the kid, touches him, tags him out. The kid then touches the bag, and the umpire called him safe. So Tanner was very disappointed. He didn't say a word. He walked back over. He threw the ball back to the pitcher. He walked back over to his little spot at first base, and he kept standing there. The umpire sees the disappointment on his face, and he walks over, and he was like, did you tag that kid out? Like, did you tag him out? And he said, yeah, I tagged him out. So the umpire reversed his decision and called the kid out, even though he originally called him safe. You can imagine, parents, how that went over, right? Some of you whose kids play baseball and everything, they didn't go over too well, and the umpire still stuck beside their decision, all because Tanner had enough integrity to do the right thing, even when no one was looking or no one could see, and walk over there and tell that umpire that he didn't actually tag him out. It's not always easy to do the right thing when someone isn't looking. Okay, I'll be straight up honest with you. Whenever I was a little kid, I used to hate spinach. And I still hate spinach. I hate it with a passion. I hate spinach. It's nasty. I don't like it. But my mom, whenever I was real little, used to make me sit at the table. And I'd have my little spoonful of spinach there. All I had to do was eat it, and I could get up. And I could go outside and start playing again or whatever. But I refused. There would be times where I would sit there for hours and not eat my spinach. One time, I got the bright idea, because my mom had left me in the kitchen by myself, she won't know if I go dump it in the trash. So you know what I did? I snuck into the kitchen and dumped it in the trash. And I sat down real quick and went, I'm done. She would come in there and be like, oh yeah, look, you finished your spinach, good job. But deep down inside, I was like, I just lied to my mom, I didn't really eat the spinach, now I'm not going to grow up and be strong. So integrity takes some time to be able to build, okay? To be a good soldier, you have to have integrity, okay? To be a good police officer, you have to have integrity. To be a good parent, you have to have integrity. To be a good teacher, you have to have integrity. To be a good student in school, you have to have integrity, okay? So let today, if it hasn't started already, let today be the day where your integrity starts, where you always start doing the right thing, even when no one is looking or no one can see you. That will build a reputation for you, You will get more confident in yourself. You will start taking pride in yourself. Your friends will be more loyal to you. You will gain more respect, and you will become a leader, and others will want to follow you. Let yourself today start taking integrity seriously, okay? So today, I mean, parents, I challenge you guys too. Teachers, these police officers over here, challenge all of you. I dare you to take integrity seriously, okay? On your feet! Always do the right thing!
You guys can sit down. Thank you. Once again, I just wanted to thank Jonathan Pope, Officer Pope, Sergeant Pope, for coming out here. He worked shift last night, so he hasn't slept since probably 1 o'clock yesterday afternoon. So if you see him outside of graduation, tell him thank you.
Thank you, buddy.
I would also like to ask Principal Dr. Gene Lloyd to come back up here. We have a small token for him as well for his thanks. And before we end, I would just like to say a personal thank you to the administrators, to my coworkers, and also to the most important people, the teachers. This was my first semester as a DARE officer, so it was took some getting used to getting into school system and learning how to run a classroom and things like that, but you guys really helped me. I enjoyed learning a lot, and I'm just very thankful for you guys, so give it up for the teachers as well. Two more things and I'll stop talking. If you look to the middle of the gym, you can see that Murfreesboro Channel 3 is here. Everybody turn and wave to the camera. Okay, you can stop waving. So Channel 3 has been recording this whole graduation. Coming up, they will be posting that, I know, on YouTube as well as on TV. We'll send out newsletters with that when we have more to come. Also, not only with them, they sponsor us as well as Skate Center West. A lot of the kids have already gotten invitations and flyers sent out, but we're having a free skate night for all the DARE students on May the 21st at 5 o'clock to 7:15, 7:30-ish. Parents, it's very important that you come back to pick the kids up at 7:30 if y'all do decide to come. Students, it's very important that y'all wear your DARE shirts with you. You'll get to get pizza, a drink, a candy bar, and a drink. Regardless, you'll get to skate and have fun with all your classmates. Parents and other family members, y'all are welcome to come and skate as well for a couple bucks. But other than that, that's the big step to come. Once again, I just want to say thank you to everybody here in this gym. It's been a great semester, and I look forward to many more. So thank you all for showing up. Remember to make safe decisions and stay violence free. Thank you.